Question of the week. A viewer asked me, can you survive charging your electric car regularly off of just a 120-volt outlet? The answer is yes, but it depends on how much you're driving on a daily basis. In the North America, there's generally two regularly common styles of 120-volt outlets. We have the NEMA 515, which is a 15-amp outlet, provides 12 amps per hour charge rate, and the NEMA 520, which is a 20-amp outlet and provides up to 16 amps continuous charge rate. The difference is about 30 to 33% faster or higher charge rate with the 20-amp if it's available. Generally, you're going to see the 15-amp in older construction, older homes, and residential settings, whereas you're going to see the 20-amp more so in commercial, apartment buildings, newer apartment buildings, condos, and mostly new construction. Now, the charge rates you're going to get a roughly 3 to 5 miles per hour range back with the 15 amp adapter, and roughly 5 to 10 miles per hour back with the 20 amp adapter. Now, charge rate is also going to vary depending on the line voltage. The lower the voltage is, the less power you're going to get. The amperage is going to always be the same, but the amount of power you can get at that amperage is going to be lower. Volts times amps equals watts. On a day-to-day basis, we'll base it off of an overnight charge, you're going to get roughly 40 to 60 miles range back with the 15-amp outlet or adapter. With the 20-amp adapter, you're going to get roughly 60 to 100 miles back per night. So, think of it this way. If you're driving less than you're gaining back, see where I'm going with this? If you're driving less than you're gaining back on a day-to-day basis, you will be just fine charging off of 120-volt outlet. Or if, say, you don't drive a lot for a couple days and then you do some more driving, you can bank. It's not like it just disappears. You can bank your power. So if you have like 3 days where you're not driving very much, you can get back 150, 200 miles of range. I mean, if you're flat dead and you're going to full, you're only looking at 4 days and you got a full charge. So it can really add up. Plus, if you have the option of, say, a supercharger nearby, and I'm at the newly opened Oak Creek Supercharger. It's actually pretty close to my home. It's only about a 5-minute drive to get here. It just opened up last week Friday, so 3 days ago. Just giving it a test out. Makes it a lot easier. On a regular day-to-day, night-to-night usage, you plug in at home, and on those occasions where you know you're going to need more, plug in at a supercharger or find a public J1772 240-volt station or a high-powered wall charger somewhere, and you can always bank up or top off a little bit more than you to help you along your way. It's perfectly fine to do. Don't hesitate at using the supercharger network. It's here for you to charge. Don't feel bad. Now, if you're charging up every day at that supercharger, at that point, yeah, try and find a way to get a 240-volt outlet for you to charge up at. That being said, there are ways also, if it's not cost-effective to run a new higher-powered outlet or line to your garage or your parking space, you could very well convert an existing 120-volt outlet to a 240-volt outlet. A couple requirements. You're going to have to consult an electrician for your specific case. But it's generally okay, especially if it's a dedicated outlet. Say you have you live in a condo, and you have your own garage, and your garage has a dedicated outlet for you, and you're using it to charge your car. It's 120 volts, say a 20 amp outlet. You can convert that 20 amp outlet from 120 volts to a 240 volts. You switched out the single pole breaker, put in the two pole breaker, tandem breaker, and now you got 240 volts going to that outlet. Now you're going to also have to change the plug style, so someone doesn't go plugging in, you know, a random object or item into that outlet and frying it because they're expecting 120 volts. So you'd have to put in that 240 volt outlet. But now you can charge at twice the speed. Double the voltage, you double the amount of power to the car. Actually, a little more than that. because the 120 volt car charging on 120 volts is not as efficient as it is on 240. You're looking at about 70% charging efficiency on 120 volts and approximately, I believe it was around close to 90% efficiency at 240 volts. And Tesla does have 20 amp 240 volt adapters available now. Even more with the new UMCs they're releasing for the Model 3s, and they're also, I think, supplying those for the Model S and X now. I have the old style, which has an overall faster charge, up to 40 amps, whereas the new style has a maximum, I believe, of 32 amps. So you can always use the same wire run as long as you match the correct amperage outlet and breaker for the wiring. So if it was a 15 amp outlet before at 120 volts, it has to be a 15 amp outlet at 240 volts. Now, I also say don't do this unless it's a dedicated outlet. So if that same garage outlet, and I mean, they're not supposed to share outlets from like a garage on the same breaker as, you know, inside the house. You really shouldn't do that. But come on, we all know electricians take shortcuts all the time. Things don't happen how they're supposed to. So if it's a shared outlet with other areas of the house, don't do it. But if it's a dedicated outlet just for your garage, just for you to charge, maybe think about having an electrician come out and convert it. It's relatively cheap. You're actually looking at only maybe $30, not even in parts. You need a circuit breaker and a new outlet, a new outlet to plug into. So what would have been 40 to 60 miles per night is now 80 to 120 miles per night. What was 60 to 100 is now 120 to 200 miles per night. It's a big difference. Plus, you know, you got to factor in the increased efficiency. So, yes, you can survive off of a 120 volt outlet. And my friend Robert, who's probably watching this right now, he did so for almost a year until I finally said, come on, let's put that NEMA 1450 in there. And now he has a 1450. Now he just needs another car to plug into it. But in the meantime, he's also using it for his generator for backup power. So that's that. Yes, you can survive off of a 120 volt. outlet. If you found this helpful, please consider liking the video, subscribing. If you didn't like the video, make sure to thumbs down. If you did like it, thumbs up. If you would like to help support my channel, I have a link to Patreon in the description box below, or you can mine some cryptocurrency via the support link also in the description box below. You just open that up, hit start mining, and maybe let it go overnight. And that'll mine some cryptocurrency for me to help support the channel. If you are interested in buying a Tesla Model S or X, consider using my Tesla referral code. See you next video.